So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247 and guys, a very happy new year to all of you. May this new year brings you a lot of happiness and joy. So let's begin with the session and guys, let me tell you, in today's session I will bring to you the very important and the very demanding National Family Health Survey 5 of phase 1. All right, so let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are new here, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon so that you can receive all the notifications regarding all the videos. So let's begin with the session and let's talk about NFHS first. The basic facts about NFHS, let's talk about it first and then we will move on to the data of NFHS 5. And remember one thing, that this is phase 1 of NFHS 5, alright. This is phase 1 of NFHS 5 for 22 states and UTs. 17 states and 5 UTs, the data has been released by the government, and for the rest of the states and UT we have to wait more. And remember one thing, in today's session we will discuss the data in four categories, okay? Overall highest, overall lowest, highest or lowest among the states, and highest or lowest among the UTs. All right, so let's talk about the NFHS first, the basic facts about this survey. So the nodal agency guys for this survey is International Institute for Population Sciences, which is located in Mumbai. That's very important fact, okay? And there are other organizations also which are contributing in formulation of this survey, like ORC Macro, which is in USA, and East West Center, which is a Hawaiian organization, all right? And if we talk about the NFHS chronology, so this is the fifth NFHS as we all know. So when was the first NFHS launched? So it was for the year 1992-1993, then we have 98-99, after that 05-06, then we have 15-16, and finally we have 18-19. So this year jo NFHS 20 ka jo hamara NFHS hai 2020 ka, uska jo data hai wo kaun se year ka hai, 2018-19 ka. The data in the 2020 NFHS is from the year 2018-19, so you should remember this chronology also, okay? And now if we talk about the indicators this year, so this year guys there are 131 indicators, and guys it is impossible to learn each and every indicator. Har indicator ke bare mein aapko yaad rakhna is not possible, and that is also not important for the exam. In the exam only the most important indicators are being asked, okay? And these are the new dimensions that have been taken into account in the NFHS 5, which are preschool education, disability, access to toilet facility, death registration. Other than these, methods and reasons for abortion and bathing practices during menstruation. So these are some new dimensions that have been taken into account in this NFHS, that is in the NFHS 5. Alright. And now guys, let's move on to the indicators and the overall highest, overall lowest, highest or lowest among states, and highest or lowest among UTs. And remember guys, highest and ye jo highest or lowest hai, ye data mein given nahi hai. Maine pure sare data ko ek शीट पे जॉट डाउन किया, देन आई हैव कम टू दिस कंक्लूजन दैट कौन कौन से स्टेट हाईएस्ट है, कौन कौन से स्टेट लोएस्ट है, कौन सा स्टेट्स में हाईएस्ट है, कौन से यूटीज में हाईएस्ट है, एंड आई थिंक इससे ज्यादा आपसे एग्जाम में नहीं पूछा जाएगा, ओके? सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द वेरी फर्स्ट इंडिकेटर विच टॉक्स अबाउट पॉपुलेशन बिलो 15 ईयर्स ऑफ एज. सो हाउ मेनी पीपल आर इन आर कंट्री विच आर बिलो 15 ईयर्स ऑफ एज. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट ओवरऑल हाइएस्ट is in Bihar, that is 37.3% population of Bihar is under 15. Overall lowest it is Goa, that is 19.1%. Then highest or lowest among states, it will be Bihar and Goa of course, okay? And talking about the UTs, so highest or lowest among UTs, highest it is Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, and the percentage is 25.4, while for Andaman and Nicobar it is 20.8%. So this is the very first indicator that you should remember and that you have to remember, okay? Moving on to the next indicator, which is the sex ratio of the population. I hope you all know what is sex ratio, that's females per 1000 males, okay? So first of all, overall highest it is in Lakshadweep, that is 1187, okay? So on the 1000 males, there are 1187 females in Lakshadweep, okay? Talking about the overall lowest, so that's very low, 827, just that's very less number guys. Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, it has the very less sex ratio as we compare to the country. Kerala, it is 1121, it is highest among the states. Gujarat has the lowest sex ratio, and which is 965. Lakshadweep, again 87, it is highest among the UTs of course, and it is highest also overall. Dadra and Nagar Haveli, highest, lowest among UTs, and it is lowest also overall. Okay. So this is the second indicator. Now let's talk about the another indicator. Sex ratio at birth for children born in the last 5 years. So sex ratio at birth ki agar hum baat karein, the overall highest it is Ladakh, which is 1125, and we all know Ladakh is a union territory. Then overall lowest, it is again a UT, Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, 817. If you talk about the highest sex ratio among the states, that is of Tripura, 1028, and Goa, it is 838. All right. Now talking about the UTs, so highest, of course, it is Ladakh, 1125, and lowest, it is Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, which is 817. And the very important fact that you should remember, that sex ratio at birth is less than 900 for three states. Three states aise hain jinka sex ratio at birth 900 se bhi kam hai. Aur wo teen states kaun se hain? Goa, Himachal Pradesh aur Telangana. And there is one UT also, which is Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu. Okay. So Goa, Himachal Pradesh and Telangana have sex ratio less than 900, and there is one UT which is Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, which has a sex ratio less than 900. All right. Moving on to the next indicator, which is population living in household with electricity. That is very interesting indicator, guys, because there is only one state in our country which have all the households having electricity, that is 100% households with electricity, and that state is Goa. Okay, Goa has the 100% households with electricity, so of course it is the overall highest. Overall lowest, if we talk about Meghalaya, that's 91.9%, and that is also not too less. So in future we can expect all the states, all the households will have electricity in our country. Highest or lowest among state, it is Goa and Meghalaya respectively, 191.9%. If we talk about UTs, so Lakshadweep has the highest, that's 99.8, very close to 100%. Bas honei wala 0.2% ka difference hai. Andaman, it is 97.6%, which is lowest among UTs. But remember, the overall lowest is Meghalaya, it is 91.9%. All right. And moving on to the next indicator, which is women who are literate, the literacy rate of women. So overall highest it is Kerala, that's 98.3%, or Kerala hamesha hi literacy rate mein zyada hota hai. So women ka literacy rate jo hai Kerala mein, that is very high, 98.3%, that is highest in our country. Overall lowest it is Bihar, as expected. Again, once again, Bihar is at the lowest in terms of literacy rate. Just 57.5% women in Bihar are literate. Highest or lowest among state, it is again Kerala and Bihar, 98.3 and 57.5. And talking about the UTs, so the overall, the highest literacy rate among women in UTs in Lakshadweep, 96.5%, while in Ladakh, it is 76.8%, that is too less. And Ladakh mein literacy rate kam hone ke bahut valid reasons hain, because wahan pe infrastructure ki jo hai, bahut zyada kami hai, so government is working towards it. Okay, and there are only 4 states which have this percentage more than 90%. That is very alarming for us. Okay. Keval 4 states hamare desh mein aise hain jahan pe women ka literacy rate 90% se zyada hai, and these are Goa, Kerala, Himachal Pradesh and Mizoram, and rest of the states and UTs all have the women literacy rate less than 90%. Okay. So now let's move on to next indicator, which is men who are literate. Overall highest it is Lakshadweep, 99.1%. That's close, very close to 100%, just 0.9% is left. Overall lowest, it is Bihar, 78.1%, as expected, as I told you, Bihar literacy rate mein hamesha se hi peeche raha hai, census mein bhi peeche raha hai. So again, it is overall lowest in terms of literacy rate among men. Highest or lowest among states, it is Kerala. Now don't confuse between the overall highest and highest among states. Highest among state, it is Kerala, 98.2. While overall highest, it is Lakshadweep, 99.1. Okay. Bihar, the lowest among state, 78.5. And talking about the highest or lowest among UTs, so Lakshadweep, 99.1%, as mentioned here, while J&K has the men literacy rate as 91.5%, which is lowest among the UTs. All right. And now let's talk about the total fertility rate. I hope you all know what is total fertility rate, that is children per woman. So overall highest it is Bihar. Bihar ka overall highest hai. And kitna target hona chahiye, you have to write down in the comments. What is the target that we have to achieve in the case of total fertility rate? What should be the ideal total fertility rate write down in the comment section. Overall highest it is Bihar 3.0. Overall lowest it is Sikkim 1.1. Highest or lowest among states, again Bihar and Sikkim 3 and 1.1 respectively. And talking about the UTs, so highest it is Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, that's 1.8. While Andaman and Ladakh, it is 1.3. And remember one more important thing, that there are three states, केवल तीन स्टेट्स ऐसे हैं जहां पे TFR 2 से ज्यादा है, विच आर बिहार, मेघालय एंड मणिपुर. ओके, बिहार का तो बहुत ही ज्यादा 3 है. ओके, सो दैट इज अबाउट टोटल फर्टिलिटी रेट. नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द नियोनेटल मोर्टिलिटी रेट. ओवरऑल हाईएस्ट बिहार 34.5, ओवरऑल लोएस्ट इट इज केरला 3.4. सो केरला इज परफॉर्मिंग वेरी वेल इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द नियोनेटल मोर्टिलिटी रेट, एंड बिहार इज परफॉर्मिंग वेरी पुअरली टॉकिंग अबाउट द नियोनेटल मोर्टिलिटी रेट. And talking about the highest, so Bihar it is 34.5, बहुत ज्यादा है. Kerala 3.4 among lowest among the states. Talking about the UTs, highest Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu 21.4, while JNK it is 9.8. Okay. And now, and guys remember, neonatal mortality rate में Lakshadweep के लिए data नहीं दिया गया है, so we can't consider Lakshadweep here. Infant mortality rate, so again Bihar is has the highest infant mortality rate, that is a whooping 46.8. That's very high number. Overall lowest it is again Kerala 4.4. So both in neonatal mortality rate and infant mortality rate, Bihar and Kerala are at the top and at the bottom. Okay, and of course highest or lowest among states it is again Bihar and Kerala with 46.8 and 4.4. UTs ki baat karein to Dadra and Nagar Haveli once again. And JNK once again is the lowest. Dadra and Nagar Haveli it is 31.8, while JNK it is 16.3. Okay. And now moving ahead with the maternal mortality rate. Once again it's Bihar, Kerala, Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu and JNK. So in all these three, neonatal mortality rate, infant mortality rate, once again infant mortality rate and this one, maternal mortality rate, the top pe is Bihar. The bottom pay it is Kerala, then among UTs it is Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, and lowest it is Jammu and Kashmir among UTs. So overall highest again it is Bihar 56.4, very high. Overall lowest it is Kerala 5.2, very good. Highest again Bihar and Kerala, and talking about the UTs, so Dadra and Nagar Haveli it is 37.5 and 18.5 JNK. Okay. And now let's move on to the next indicator, that is total unmet need for family planning. ऐसे कितने percentage family हैं हमारे देश में जिनकी family planning की जो need है वो पूरी नहीं हो रही है. So in this indicator, overall highest it is Meghalaya with a 26.9% families who have unmet need for their family planning. Okay. Overall lowest it is Andhra Pradesh 4.7%. केवल 4.7% लोग ऐसे हैं वहाँ पे families ऐसी हैं जिनकी unmet जो भी अनमेट नीड है फॉर फैमिली प्लानिंग वो नहीं हो रही है. हाईएस्ट अमंग स्टेट्स इट इज मेघालय 26.9, आंध्र प्रदेश लोएस्ट 4.7, एंड हाईएस्ट अमंग यूटीज इट इज अंडमान, वाइल लोएस्ट इट इज जम्मू एंड कश्मीर विद 7.8%. ओके, एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द अनदर इंडिकेटर विच इज मदर्स हु हैड एटलीस्ट 4 एंटीनेटल केयर विजिट्स. एंटीनेटल केयर विजिट्स क्या होता है? विच इज टू अ डॉक्टर बिफोर बर्थ. ओके, बिफोर बर्थ ऑफ द चाइल्ड. So in that indicator, overall highest it is Goa. Goa mein 93% mothers aisi hain who had at least 4 antenatal care visits before the birth of their child. Overall lowest it's Nagaland, that's very less, 20.7%. Just 20.7% women are there who had at least 4 antenatal care visits. Highest among states it is Goa, and of course lowest it is again Nagaland, 20.7. Highest among UTs it is Lakshadweep, that's 88.3, while lowest it is 78.4% of Ladakh. Okay. Now let's move on to another very important indicator, that's institutional births. So in the terms of institutional birth, in Kerala, approximately 100% births are institutional, that is 99.8%. Okay. While talking about the lowest in Nagaland, it is just 45.7%. It is not even 50% births which are institutional in Nagaland. So that is very alarming for the state Nagaland. Highest among state it is again Kerala and Nagaland 45.7. Highest among UTs it is Lakshadweep 99.6%, and while Ladakh it is 92.4%. Okay. And talking about the children aged 12 to 23 months fully vaccinated, guys, this indicator again is very important. Let me tell you, all the indicators are very important. There is not even a single indicator here that we are discussing is not important. We are discussing 19 or 20 indicators from 131 indicators. So you have to consider these 20 indicators at least. All right. So children aged 23 months who are fully vaccinated among it, overall highest it is. That's very surprising. Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, jo generally har jagah pe lowest hai, yahan pe highest hai, 94.9%. Overall lowest it is Nagaland again, 57.9%. Nagaland is not performing well in many indicators. Highest Himachal Pradesh among the states, and remember it is an UT. Overall highest it is UT, Dadra and Nagar Haveli 94.9. While highest among state it is Himachal Pradesh 89.3. While Nagaland it is 57.9, okay. And highest among UTs it's Dadra and Nagar Haveli, as I told you, 94.9. While UTs mein lowest kaun hai? Andaman, that's 77.8%, okay. And now let's move on to another indicator, guys. Prevalence of diarrhea in 2 weeks preceding the survey. Survey hone se 2 hafte pehle jo diarrhea ki prevalence thi un states mein, unki baat kar rahe hain, states mein ya UTs mein. So overall highest Bihar. Bihar mein sabse zyada prevalence thi diarrhea ki 2 weeks preceding the survey. Bihar has the highest prevalence of diarrhea 2 weeks preceding the survey with a percentage of 13.7. Okay. Overall lowest it was Lakshadweep. That's 2.3%. Lakshadweep is performing very well here. Highest among state it is Bihar 13.7. Lowest it is Goa 3.2. And don't confuse. Overall lowest it is Lakshadweep. That's 2.3. While lowest among states it's Goa. That is 3.2. Okay. So the numbers are in reverse order. Highest among UTs Ladakh 8.5% and lowest among UTs it's Lakshadweep 2.3%. Okay. Now let's move on to another indicator that's very important, guys. Children under 5 who are stunted. So stunted ka jo target hai wo portion abhiyan may be included hai, as you all know. So talking about this indicator, overall highest it's Meghalaya 46.5%. So in Meghalaya approximately 50% children are under 5 are there who are stunted. Overall lowest it's Sikkim 22.3%, that is very near to the target. Highest among states Meghalaya 46.5, Sikkim 22.3 as mentioned above. Highest among UTs Dadra and Nagar, that's 39.4, while lowest it's Andaman 22.5%, that is also very close to the target of the stunting. All right. Now let's move on to another indicator, children under 5 who are wasted, that is again also very important, guys. Overall highest Maharashtra 25.6%, okay. Overall lowest Mizoram, that's 9.8%. Maharashtra mein child wasting bahut zyada hai, 25.6%, although it is very close to the target, but yes, we have to do more. Highest among states Maharashtra 25.6%, lowest it is Mizoram 9.8%. Then highest among UTs it's Dadra and Nagar Haveli 21.6%. So once again, it is performing poorly. Dadra and Nagar Haveli, highest percentage of children under 5 who are wasted. So 21.6%. Andaman, that's 16%. Okay. Now next is also very important. Children under 5 who are underweight. Overall highest, once again, it's our Bihar, which is at the top, 41%. Overall lowest, it's Mizoram, 12.7%. Highest or lowest among state, Mizoram and Bihar and Mizoram respectively. And highest or lowest among UTs, it's Dadra and Nagar Haveli once again. And Ladakh, that's 20.4%. Dadra and Nagar Haveli, percentage is how much? 38.7%. Alright. Moving ahead, women who have comprehensive knowledge of HIV or AIDS. So that's guys, second last indicator that we are doing. Iske baad ek aur hai, and that's it. Women who have comprehensive knowledge of HIV AIDS, overall highest, it's Mizoram, 64.1%. Alright. And once again, Bihar. That's 10.3%. Only 10.3% women in Bihar have the comprehensive knowledge of HIV AIDS. Just 10.3%. So Bihar, highest it's Mizoram and Bihar, 64.1 and 10.3. Highest among UTs it's Lakshadweep 46.9. While lowest it is Andaman 14.9%. Okay. And now let's move on to the very last indicator. So that is the last indicator, guys. Iske baad aapko kuch nahi padhna. NFHS 5 ko aapko haath bhi nahi lagana. Kahin bhi kuch nahi dekhna. That is more than enough. Men who have comprehensive knowledge of HIV or AIDS. Overall highest, it's Goa, 67.2%. 67.2%. And overall lowest, it's West Bengal. So you can see, guys, the comprehensive knowledge about HIV AIDS is very less in our country. In the women section, it was just 64.1%, which was the highest percentages. Okay. And in the men section, it is just 67.2%. So we have, government have to do something. Overall lowest, it's West Bengal, 15.5%, just 15.5% men knows comprehensively about HIV/AIDS. Highest, it's Goa and West Bengal, 67.2 and 15.5. Then highest among UTs, it's Lakshadweep, 65.5. And while among UTs, once again, Dadar and Nagar, it is 28.1%. Okay. So guys, these are the indicators and these are the highest, overall lowest, highest among states or lowest among states, highest or lowest among UTs. These are the 19 or 20 indicators that you have to cover in your exam. Isse zyada you don't have to cover anything from NFHS 5. And I can guarantee you, isse zyada exam mein nahi pucha jayega. In fact, bahut sare indicators isme aise bhi the, jo ki nahi puche jayenge, but still I have taken that to be on the safe side. Now the question arises that how do we have to remember this? Itna sara datum yaad kaise karenge? So that is not a new question, and you don't have to remember all the data in a single day. Okay, you don't have only one day left for your exam. There is a lot of time. So keep on revising the data and you will be definitely able to remember all the data like you have remembered for the data for the census 2011. There are various percentages in the census 2011 as well. So you must have remembered all the data, na? So here also you have to remember all the data, and I am sure that you will be able to remember the data. So guys, thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.